Hello and welcome to Netflix and Grill, the show where I rip off my favourite faces from the world of TV and film. Today I'm going to be Little Miss Blair Waldorf, as you can probably tell from the headband. This was at the request of the lovely Rian Edwards, so I'm very excited to do Blair. I loved Gossip Girl, I watched it so much. So let's go through the Blair checklist. So number one, headband. Yes, got it. It's from Zara, it's velour. It's a little bit 90s and it kind of hides the little join of my wig and my real hair, because I'm not that brunette. Pearl necklace. Obviously, every Park Avenue princess needs one. And I've got my Blair-esque pussycat bow. So headband and shirt are from Zara, and pearls are from, I forget, Angel, maybe? Shop and Angel? They are real, but they're quite misshapen, which makes them cheap. So yeah, let's get started. Basically, Blair has got like quite a sort of taupey, smoky eye, which I've recreated here on this side. Obviously this side I've left blank for your delectation. It's really soft and smoked out, a little bit of depth sort of close to the lashes, and then I have added one little cluster of fake lashes at the edge just to elongate my eye, and then one teeny tiny little cluster here as well, otherwise it's just mascara. Lightly defined brow, kind of glowy-ish, not too glowy skin. Blair's actually quite matte. But I have got a little bit of highlighter here. Yeah, there we are. Let's get started. So the palette that I'm using is by Becca, and it's the Ombre Nudes eye palette. So to begin with, I'm going to use this really light shade here all over the lid. And I'm using a big fluffy Morphe brush to do that. I've actually primed my eyelid already because I get really greasy eyelids. And I've primed using the Urban Decay eye primer, which is called this one. Yeah, in Eden. So it's just like a nice pale colour. Then I'm going to go in with the next darkest, lightest shade, same brush, to tap off the excess. And then I'm just going to take that into the socket. Now, Blair likes a kind of taupey eye, and actually this colour's perfect because it's, as you can see, like, it's not too warm, and it's not too cool. It's like the perfect taupe, basically. So I'm bringing that all the way into the socket, and I'm just kind of using windscreen wiper motions, and then kind of blending out with like little circles as well. And I'm going all the way into the corner of the eye, and then bringing it out just with whatever's left on the brush. I'm just bringing that loosely kind of out towards the end of my brow. So you can already see there's a bit of dimension that's been created from that. Then I'm going to take a smaller brush, a little rounded brush, and I'm going to go into the next lightest or darkest, the one in the middle. So this colour I'm just concentrating on the edge of the eye. I think me and Blair have got fairly similarly shaped eyes, so the aim of the game is to kind of make them look bigger and more elongated. And I'm just going to take whatever's left on the brush underneath the eye. Not too much, because actually most of the colour is concentrated on the lid. So you can see I've kind of got my Blair base. I'm just going back in with the fluffy brush just to blend everything out. So that's the first kind of step. Then I am going to use my Physicians Formula pencil in Nude Eye Look. I think that was the pack it's from, but basically it's just a dark brown pencil. It's really good, it's really sort of strong pigment and it lasts really well. I hate doing this bit, it really creeps me out, but basically what you do is lift up your lid. Sorry, it really freaks me out. Oh god, I hate it. And you just colour in between the lashes. Really helps to make your eye look more defined. Without taking up any lid space. Anyway, it's done. see it's just kind of given a bit. I'll probably do this bit a bit more, to be fair. Oh god, I hate it so much. Okay, so that's the definition bit done. Then I close my eye, which is fine, and just kind of rub the pencil between my lashes. So yeah, you're trying to almost get the colour between the eyelashes. And then do a little bit at the edge, not too much. Make sure you've got lots of pencil on there. Little angled brush. I just gently run that along the edge just to kind of blend it out a little bit. The faces I pull, seriously, sorry. A bit more here. You can see that's just given a little bit more definition, Blair-like definition. I'm actually going to put a little bit more here at the edge. Almost wing it out a little bit. Blair never really has like a full-on wing, but I'm going to use this little rounded edge just to blend it out a bit more. That's what I need for my eye shape. So I'm not going to completely rip her off. I want it to look right for me as well. Right, now to give a little bit more definition, I'm going to use the Lady Gaga, such cool packaging, liner, eye liner. And I'm just going to put that, rest that almost gently against the bottom of my lashes, roots of my lashes. And then with the point, I just, see if you can see, like I angle it out that way. And then I just do tiny little mini baby wing and then connect everything up. Much again, and then if it sort of, you see how it sort of separates a bit, you can just throw on your brush over the top, which helps to kind of give that smoky look, but you still get the definition from the liner as well. And then with my finger, so I always did that automatically, my ring finger, I just kind of bring it up and it just helps to sharpen up the side a little bit more. And then what you can do is go over it with a little bit of brown shadow, like that. That just sort of sets it. I've already got a bit of mascara on, I'll put a bit more on afterwards. So I'm now going to go in with my false lash. So I'm using the Easy Lash from Huda Beauty Harmony. Which is just like a little corner lash, so I'm just going to pop that on the side. So I've just coated the lash, not very well. Hang on. Lash is now coated, so we let that dry a little bit, and then that's going to go on the side of my eye. Yeah. And just use your fingers to kind of angle it the way you want it to be. There. And then I usually use the end of my tweezers just to push it up a little bit and pat it down, comme ça. It's very Blair, speaking a little bit of French there. And just kind of, sorry, let's actually explain what I'm doing. I'm using my tweezers to lift the lash slightly. How nice is that? I love a corner lash. The other ones that I'm using are these little individualies from Primark, to be honest. I can't even remember where they're from. They're good because they're just like little clumps of three. If you can see that. Just like three little individual lashes. So I just dot them into the glue. And then, this glue's been drying for a while, so it on. I'm putting it kind of in the middle of the eye. There we are. So everything's in situ. Don't worry about the white glue because that will dry. So they're pretty even. What do you think? I think we're pretty much there. Oh, I forgot to put mascara on the lower lashes as well. So I can do that while the glue's drying. So I'm using the Pure Fully Charged, which is so cool. Look, it's got a massive light in it. You can't really see because of the really sunny, but it does, trust me. And I'm just gonna coming out. And the lower lashes. Just bringing it through. Bringing it down through the lashes. You can kind of see the light of it. And then I know this isn't fully dry, so I might live to regret this, but I'm just going to bring it through the base of the lash. Just to join up the fake lash with the real lash. Just see what's happening here. Yeah, they're alright. They're on. Not quite close enough to the root, but. There we go. And then you can obviously always go back in, if you can still see any glue, you just go back in with your liquid liner and run it along. So there we are. I've already done my brows off camera. I used the MUA Makeup Academy Brow Define Micro Precision Eyebrow Pencil, which is really cool because on one end it's got like a little brush, so you can brush through the lashes. And then on the other side, it has this teeny tiny little pointy eyebrow thing, so you can kind of go through like this, and just like look for any gaps in your brows basically, and then fill them in. Okay. So her lips are quite sort of nude and natural, so I'm going to use a MAC lip pencil, so tiny now because I've used it so much. Boldly Bare. It's a really beautiful colour. It's kind of like, I'll show you my hand, a sort of nudie pinky colour. I use this on brides a lot because it's really good. It's sort of in between nude and a pink, which is perfect for a kind of natural lip look. Over the top of that, I'm going to put this Glam lip gloss, and it's by Cage of Ice. I'm probably saying that completely wrong, so sorry for that, and it's in the shade Tenderness. This is so heavy, like this top part's metal and then the bottom part's glass, so it's a very luxe lip gloss. And I'm not gonna massively overline, because actually Blair hasn't got massive lips, so if anything I'll probably go inside my lip line rather than outside. You can see it's really close to my natural lip colour this. I'm actually going a little bit inside my natural lip line, as I said. Kind of trying to make my lips look a bit smaller. Can't imagine anyone on Instagram wanting to do that currently. Definitely a massive lip trend at the moment. Actually, what I might do with this is take it all over the lip and kind of use it as a base for my gloss. It's a really nice colour. You can see it's just kind of like the perfect nude, basically. There we are. First of two. Then I'm going to use the beautiful lip balm gloss thing, which is completely natural. It smells really nice. And you just put a little layer of that on top. Just gives a nice shine. It's not sticky at all. It's a really luxe lip gloss, this one.
And here I am applying said lip gloss.
Like, I might need a little bit more shimmer on my skin. So I'm going to use the Beauty Pie shimmer bricks, which are very similar to the Hourglass ones, but a fraction of the price. And I'm just going to run my brush through all of them. This is really nice because it just gives you a really soft, kind of undetectable shimmer. And it kind of powders your skin without leaving it looking too matte, because it shiny box. Little horn. Someone's excited to be out. Feeling quite Blair. I just want to blend that in a little bit there. I just noticed something's a little bit sticking outy. Give them both a little blend. I want to give myself a little spritz with the Becca Skin Love face spray. A little shake. I don't know why I do that. Can't hurt. And just give yourself a little spritz. So relaxing. You can see that's just kind of given the skin a little bit more of a glow. True to its name. I'm going to take this little hair grip out. Oh god, don't look at the wig join. Well, blend the fake and the not fake hair together a little bit more. And there we have it. I'm off to go and meet Chuck for a delicious drink and probably a really expensive dinner. Why not give it a try, have fun, and try and create your own Blair Waldorf, and share it with me, hashtag Netflix and Grill. And as always, if you've got any questions about what I did maybe before I got to the eyes, the skincare, then yeah, just send me a message. So let me know what you think, if you like this look, if you're going to give it a go, and also who you'd like me to have a go at next. I was thinking maybe the cheerleaders from Cheer, try and make myself look like a 15-year-old cheerleader, which was probably a bit difficult, but who cares? Probably reuse this bow for that, because they all have those big bows in their hair, don't they? Anyway, I digress. Have a lovely day, whatever you're doing, and take care, and I'll see you again soon. Thanks, bye!